This video will create the assembly model for the wheel assembly. So we're going to create a new. Now we're going to do, excuse me, what we want to do for our assembly is standard millimeter IAM. So make sure you use this one. Place the components. Now remember, start with the kind of the biggest piece or the main piece, and so that would be in this case the base of the part. Oops, try that again. Base. I said click it, right click, and say okay. I forgot to click it. Let's add the next logical piece is probably these the bracket. No. My advice is always to try to rotate the part to get close to its final resting position. It'll make your life a lot easier. So what I want to do here is, let's see, let's rotate it about the Y. And about the Z, and that'll be that one over there. So click it and say okay. And let's constrain that. I'll use the bottom and the top of that surface. Apply that. Gonna use this. Oops. Use this back. And then that edge of the lip right there. And I'll choose that side and that side. Now, if it doesn't move right, then remember you've got two options here. Try the second solution. That's it. And say okay. Right, let's do the same for the other side. Second bracket, same thing. Let's try to rotate this around. Keep going. There we go. Click it, right click, say okay. So we'll do exactly the same in terms of constraining bottom and the top. Do the back. And then that lip right there. And then that edge. Whoops. And that edge. And that's good. Okay, I think next I'll probably add that shaft or the axle, sorry. Let's see, we'll rotate that about the Z, I think. Oops, no, X. There we go. Right click, say okay. Now, probably the smart move here is let's just use the mid plane. So if we go to that axle, open up the origin and find that mid plane. If you don't have a mid plane, it's easy to make. Just go up here to plane and then click on the two ends and that'll put a mid plane. And then we're going to do the same thing with that base. Let's open up the origin, find that mid plane, and let's constrain that. So we'll do center line of that axle to the center line of there, and then we'll just use the mid plane and made it to the mid plane. And try your second solution if nothing happens. Say okay, that looks good. Let's see, I'm going to turn that off. Don't need that mid plane anymore. And let's go ahead and add the wheel. So, oops, okay. So, same thing here. Let's put a mid plane on that wheel. And again, if you don't have one, let's say you don't have a mid plane, just go up to plane, to mid plane between two planes, and then click on the front of that. Oops, let's see. Get a better view. Try that again. On there. Sorry, I was thinking of SolidWorks. You can make that work. Easiest thing to do if you want to add a plane is just open up that part. So you'll see across the bottom of my screen, I always have the individual models there. So just go back to your wheel, plane, and do mid plane. Click on that surface, click on that surface, and there's your mid plane. Now, when you go back to your assembly, that's going to show up. That's the easiest way to do it. So let's go ahead and constrain that. We'll do center line to center line. And let's see, let's scoot this thing over. Try that again. So I got the center lines constrained. Now we'll do plane to plane. Again, if it doesn't move, switch to the alternate solution. Say okay. Now the reason I'm doing this is because I don't really have like a surface to mate it to. See how there's a gap between there? So the mid planes definitely works better in terms of constraining that. And now I can just come in and turn off those planes. And there's my assembly.